Here are 12 Apple Watch tips with some I bet you've never seen. Like, did you know you could turn on the flashlight of your iPhone from your Apple Watch? The fastest way to start countdowns, like when you're cooking? Hidden settings and gestures? And yes, the last three tips are actually shortcuts. First up, when you're starting a workout on Apple Watch, you don't have to wait for that countdown to finish. As soon as you tap it, if you see that countdown, just double tap, it'll skip the countdown and go right to actually counting your exercise minutes. To see that again, as soon as you start a workout, just double tap and it'll jump right to actually measuring your workout. Number two, one of the best features of Apple Watch and iPhone is you can ping your iPhone when it's lost. It'll make a sound, and if you have U1 chips, you'll be able to actually locate it using Precision Find My. But if you actually tap and hold on this icon on your Apple Watch, your iPhone will make a sound and blink the flashlight. Next, when you want to set timers, you don't even have to say the wake word or the assistant name. Just make sure to go to your settings, go down to You Know Who, and make sure you have Raise to Speak turned on. If you have the Listen For enabled, you can actually have this off and still raise your Apple Watch to speak to it. Now when you raise to lift your Apple Watch, just say a time, 5 minutes, and it will automatically start a timer for 5 minutes. You didn't have to say, hey dingus, or anything else, just say the time and it'll start. Next, your Apple Watch can actually speak the time if you want it to say it to you. Make sure to go to Settings, go down to General, go down to your Clock Settings, and if you scroll down, you'll see Speak Time. You can toggle that on. You can also choose to have it always speak the time, even if your Apple Watch is in silent mode. Then to have it speak the time, just tap and hold two fingers on the Apple Watch face.
9:26 a.m.
A little Easter egg, if you have the Mickey Mouse face on, it'll actually be his voice.
It's 9:26.
Now this next one is actually if you have a Mac and an Apple Watch. Go up to the Apple icon and then System Settings. Then from here, go down to Touch ID and Password. And if you have an Apple Watch linked to the same Apple ID as your Mac, you can enable it to unlock from Apple Watch. This will also allow you to do things like approve Apple Pay purchases and unlock secure apps. This is especially useful if you don't have a Mac with Touch ID built into the keyboard, or if you use something like a mechanical keyboard like I do. The Apple Watch can do everything that Touch ID button would normally do. Next, one of the best ways to switch between Apple Watch faces is just swipe from right to left on the watch face. You can have multiple Apple Watch faces, and it makes it easy to navigate them all. But this setting's not on by default. So click the crown, go to the Settings app, and we're actually gonna go back to the Clock Settings, and at the very top, for Swipe to Switch Watch Face, make sure that's toggled on. That's gonna let you quickly swipe between your watch faces without having to tap and hold and go into edit mode. Just swipe from left to right or right to left. Next, in recent versions of watchOS, whenever you have media playing, it could be from a HomePod or on your iPhone, it's automatically going to show you the live activity here on your watch. Well, if you're like me and you use something like background sounds on a HomePod when you're sleeping, it shows that on the Apple Watch constantly, and then you have to click the crown to see the clock. And because I have several HomePods in the house and often they're playing something, that was really cumbersome. So to change that, let's go back into the settings on Apple Watch, go down to General, and then go down to Auto Launch. Here you're going to see something called Live Activity Settings at the top. When you tap that, here you can adjust what live activities will show and take over the dock or show the full app. Now I do like some live activities from things like DoorDash or even Starbucks, so I do want them enabled, but if you scroll down, you'll see the option to customize media apps. Here you can choose to disable all media app live activities, or you can choose whether or not you want them to auto-launch. By default, they're in the smart stack, but you can turn that off here. This way the live activity will still be present, but in order to see it, you would swipe up from the bottom and then see the live activity there. Or if you want to disable live activities from media apps entirely, you can toggle them off right here. Now, even if you swipe up from the bottom and there's a HomePod or your iPhone playing media, you won't see it on your Apple Watch. I'm actually changing it to allow live activities, but turning off the auto launch setting. Next, the default behavior when you open an app on your Apple Watch is when you put your wrist down and then lift it back up, it will be back on that same app. Well, if you prefer to see the clock every time you raise your wrist, you can change that setting. Click the crown again, go back to the General Settings, then scroll down and you'll see Return to Clock as an option. When you go here, you can change the setting to after 2 minutes, so when you open an app on your Apple Watch, it'll stay active for 2 minutes. You can even go all the way up to an hour, or you can click Always, so every time you lower and raise your wrist, it will always go back to the clock. All right, before we get to some shortcuts you can use with your Apple Watch, especially the action button on Apple Watch Ultra, there are some hidden gestures you can use, like pinching and clenching your fist. For the most recent Apple Watches, you can go to Settings and then Gestures, and you can turn on Double Tap. You can also cover to mute, so if your Apple Watch starts making sounds, you just place your palm on it. But there are more gestures available to you under the Accessibility settings. Scroll down in the Accessibility settings and go to Assistive Touch. When you toggle this on, you will have to turn off double tap if you enable the assistive touch features, but you do get more options this way. Turn on hand gestures here, and then you can decide what a tap, a double tap, and what a clench of your fist will do. For instance, I can have a clench do something like bring up the control center. Let's set that, and then let's also set a double clench to show the dock, because I can never remember if it's the side button or swiping up from the bottom to access it. Now let's put the Apple Watch on and try some clenches. Now the taps would be taps like this, but I didn't program those just yet. So let's try a clench first. If I clench my wrist, it'll bring up the control center without having to touch the screen. Then if I do a double clench of my fist, it'll bring up the dock and I can see my recent applications. Now for these last three, let's set up some shortcut automations. The last one being a master action button, which will change the function depending on our focus mode, which is pretty cool. One automation I really like to do is when a workout is started to change the Apple Watch face. You can do that from your phone by tapping the plus icon, and then when you go down, you'll see Apple Watch workout is actually a trigger. When you go here, you can choose what workout type will actually trigger this automation. So you can have different watch faces per workout. We'll say when a workout starts, we want this to run immediately, don't notify when run. We'll tap next, new blank automation, and then we just need to search for watch. Then choose the set watch face action, and when you tap face, you can choose one of your Apple Watch faces. Unfortunately, you don't get a visual representation of those faces, so you do have to choose just by knowing what order your Apple Watch faces are in, but I'll choose the modular one. I leave off show and run, and when we hit done, this automation will run whenever we start a workout. All right, let's test this out. Remember, you can start a workout just by asking the assistant. Start indoor walking workout. See, it started. I'm going to double tap to skip that countdown. Now that the workout is going, let's click the digital crown and go back to our watch face. And you'll see here I have it set to a watch face where the calories, the rings, and more information having to do with workouts is readily available. Now I actually have a second automation that when a workout ends, it returns to my other watch face. So now that I ended this workout, we'll give it a second. Go back home, and then you'll see the Apple Watch change back to what I had. So you can have an automation for when a workout starts, and another one for when workout ends. Next, let's say you wanted to have a random watch face every morning, just so you can wake up to something new. You can actually set this up as an automation as well. We'll go back into shortcuts, tap the plus icon, and now let's choose time of day. We'll say every day at sunrise. Maybe we'll do an hour before sunrise if we're waking up early. We want this to run daily, run immediately, and let's hit next. New blank automation, and this we're going to need several actions. First, we want to get my watch faces. This first action is just going to get all the faces you have set for your Apple Watch. Then for the second action, we're going to use the get item from list. And instead of first item, we're going to tap and hold and choose random item. That's just going to choose a random watch face that we have. Then we're going to search for the set watch face action, and that'll be the last action here, and it's going to choose that item from the list. Keep show and run toggled off, and now we can test this to see, will it actually work? And every time I run the shortcut, it should go to a random watch face. Now it went to one of my reflection watch faces, and it's just gonna choose a random watch face each time and change it every time this automation runs. So now I'll wake up to a random watch face, and if you wanna add a bunch of watch faces, you can really have a surprise every time you wake up. I also have multiple automations for times of day, like I have watch faces that happen just on the weekend with less information, things like the solar watch face, which activates in the evenings. So setting up times of day and changing the watch face, it's another powerful thing shortcuts can do. But for the last tip, let's look at this action button shortcut that I made here based on focus mode. I'll put this as a link that you can download in the description as well. But what this does is gets your current focus, and then you can take different actions on the Apple Watch depending on that focus. So a helpful one here is when I'm in my sleep focus mode, if I ever get up in the middle of the night, I likely want the flashlight on. So if I go to sleep focus, and I'll actually change it here on my phone, which syncs to the watch. Now in my sleep focus, you see the simple change on my watch. Now you have a little bed icon. I use the astronomy watch face during sleep. Now if I click the action button on my Apple Watch, it should go to the flashlight. And there you go. I don't even have to find the flashlight on my Apple Watch. It'll just do it with the action button. Then I have other things like set silent mode if I'm not in a focus mode, and you can customize this with whatever actions you'd like. There are 12 tips for Apple Watch, and I have more coming very soon. So subscribe to the channel, hit that like button. If you have any questions about Apple Watch, iPhone, iPad, or any Apple device, let me know in the comments. We'll cover it in a future video. I also have some recent videos on iPhone and Mac tips. I'll put those right up here. And WWDC is right around the corner. I'll be there in person covering it, and I would love for you to join me here on the channel. And if you want to know more about shortcuts, I have an entire shortcuts community at create.beard.fm. Over 1,500 people have joined, with many supporting with $5 a month to get my shortcut of the week. Shortcuts GPT, which is great for using API and match text actions, and more. Links to that and the shortcuts are down in the description. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.